Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the while loop. While loop is an example for entry condition loop. So here the condition will be checked at the beginning of the loop. If the condition has been got satisfied, the while loop will get executed. If the condition has not satisfied, it comes out of the statement. So for any particular loop, we need three requirements. First one is called as an initialization. And next one is a test condition. And a third one is called as an increment or decrement statement. So when you are working with a while loop, the syntax tells that first we need to initialize the value. Initialization, we can consider it as a starting point. So after initialization of a particular value, the while has to be get written along with the test condition. Here while is a keyword which is followed with a test condition. The test condition can be any constant or it can be made use of any expression. So from this braces up to here, this is considered as the body of the while loop. A while loop can consist of a single statement or it can consist of a collection of statements. One thing you need to remember, when you are working with a while loop, increment or decrement statement should be present inside the body of the while loop only. So what happens when the program executes from top to bottom? First initialization will be get set, then it will be checked with the condition. If the condition gets satisfied, it will enter into the body of the loop. Once coming out of the body of the loop, the increment statement will be get executed. Again it goes back to the beginning of the while loop. So again the condition will be get checked, the statements will be get executed, increment statement will execute, and this process continues till the condition gets failed. So once the condition has been got failed, it will execute the remaining statements. Whatever we write below the while statement, we call it as a default statements. This is what the syntax of the while loop. Now let us see the flowchart of a while loop. See, this is what the particular control enters here. It is going to test the expression. If the expression is true, the while loop, the body of the while loop will be get executed. This is a repetition part. The arrow mark what we are seeing here, this is a repetition part. So this process continues. And when the while loop will be get terminated, whenever the condition get failed, then that means it becomes false. It comes out of the particular outside of a while loop. For this reason only we call while loop as an entry condition loop. Why we are calling it as entry condition? Because it is going to check the condition before entering the while loop itself. Now let us say few examples on the while loop.
So any type of a loop if you want to work, like for loop, while loop and do while loop, these are the three important points we need to consider. First one is called as an initialization. Second one is called as a test condition. Third one is called as an increment or decrement operator. Now let us know what do mean by the term called as a initialization. See, initialization is nothing but always it indicates a starting point. Why we call it as a starting point means, as we have seen in the definition of a loop is also called as an iterative statements, nothing but repetitive statements. If a statement has to be get repeated for a finite number of a time, see, I am using a word finite here. Finite is nothing but a starting point and it should somewhere end at some specific point. So that is what we call it as a finite part. So if a loop is starting at some point, that part we call it as an initialization. If a loop is going to end at certain point, then that part we call it as a test condition. In between starting point and end point, the loop has to move step by step. That part we call it as an increment or a decrement. Is it been clear? Shall I repeat? So these are the three important things we need to use for every loop. One is an initialization, test condition, increment or decrement. Don't use both the operators. If required, then only you use. Either you use an increment operator or you use a decrement operator. What does initialization means? Always it indicates a starting point. End point is nothing but a test condition. In between start and end, we need to move from a starting point to an end point. We need to travel. So that part we call it as an increment part. Has it been clear? Now let us see one small example. So now let us discuss about the example. So before going for the direct example on a while loop, we will try to understand the importance of a loop. So for that, what we need to do is that I will write one program which will work manually. That means I will not use any loops in the particular program. Without loops, I will first write the program. We will see the output. Later on, again, we try to implement a loop in that particular program. We will see both the particular differences. So now what I want to do is that I want to print hello for 5 times, a very simple program. So what I need to do, I will write printf hello. So did you understand what I need to do now? I want to print hello for 5 times. What I need to do? Hello. So what I, for that I have written one statement called as a printf hello. Now if I execute this program, so I am executing the program which I have been just typed now. How many times hello has been got printed? Hello has printed only one time. Now what is my requirement? I need to print it for 5 times. So what is the option? So I will copy this and again I will paste it. So how many times it will be printed now? 2 times. Yes. This is the third time, fourth time and fifth time. So now if I execute this particular program, I am going to get the output as a hello. Okay, how many times the hello has been got displayed? Hello has been got displayed for 5 times. So this is what we call as a program without any loop. See here, you can try to understand here, there is a one statement called as an hello. See the definition, what is the definition of a loop says that a loop can have a single statement or it can have a group of statement. So in my program, how many statement I am having? Only one statement, that is a hello. Now what I need to do that, hello has to be get repeated. For how many times I told? 5 times. So for that what I have written? First time, second time, third time, fourth time and fifth time. And we have been executed that particular program. Yes, the program works fine. So you may feel that there is no need of a loops. Yes, up to now there is no need of a loop. By chance if I say I want to print hello for 50 times. Then what you people are going to do then? You need to write this hello for 50 times. Printf hello, printf hello, printf hello. So what happens here? The length of the program is increasing. The same line. Line is not going to change. But you need to write it for 50 times. What is happening? The length of the program will increase. Not only the length of the program increases, even it will be taking a time also. Time consumption will be more. So to solve this particular problem, we need to introduce the concept of a loop. So if I want to introduce the concept of the loop, what are the things we need to keep it in the mind? See, these are the three things: initialization, test condition and increment operator. Now we will see this. So what I do is that I will take one variable called as a number, or let me take a count. So I am going to put a semicolon. So what is the statement has become now? This is a variable declaration. And what is the name of a variable? Count is the name of a variable of data type integer. Then see here, initialization. Initialization is nothing but the starting point. So what is the starting value of my program? How many times it should repeat now? It should repeat for 5 times. If it is repeating for 5 times, what should be the first value? That means it should go from print hello for the first time, print hello for the second time, print hello for the third time, print hello for the fourth time, print hello for the fifth time. See how I have been done? I went in the series 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now what should be the count value? The initial value, that is nothing but the starting value of a count, should be made as 1. So what is this part is called as? Initialization. Did you people have understood what do you mean with the term called as initialization? So let me make it as a comment so that it will not affect my program. So just initialization is nothing but assigning a value to a variable is called as an initialization. Remember students here, when you are working with a while loop, I am talking with a while loop, always initialization should come first. After writing initialization, we need to write a while loop. While is a keyword. So in this, what I need to do now? I need to repeat it for how many times? 5 times. That means, what is the value of a count? Count value is a 1. Count less than or equals to 5. What these 5 indicates? 5 indicates total for the 5 times my program has to work. Now, what is the value of count? 1. 1 is less than or equals to 5? Yes, it is true. If it is true, it should enter into the body of the while loop. See, already this we have seen in the syntax as well as the flow chart. While is an example for which one? Entry condition loop. If the particular condition gets satisfied at the beginning only, then only it will enter into the body of the while loop. So, inside the body of the while loop, what I need to do now? I need to write printf hello. I'm going to write printf hello. Let me write slash n and end with a semicolon. See, this is what happens. I have written initialization. This part is called as an initialization. So here this is called as a test condition. Clear? So test condition where we are writing in the with the while loop only. And this is the body. From here to here, this is the body. Now what I have missed? I have missed here increment operator. We will see what happens. If I don't write increment operator, what happens? Can you expect, can you predict what will be the output here? See here. Hello, 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 hello. It is going to print for how many times? Infinite times. Do you know what has happened? Why this problem? How many times I need? I need only for 5 times. But system is going to print it for how many times? It is printing for infinite times. Till the resource get exhausted. It goes on printing. Hello, 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 hello for many number of times. But this is a wrong output. See, you know why I am getting a continuous output? See, what is the value of a count started? It has, see, my loop has to move from, I will show it here. First time it should be first, one time it should print, second time it should print, third time it should print, fourth time it should print, and fifth time it should print. When it becomes 6, it should come out. Is it been clear? So I don't want here 6. See, what is the value of a count have become? Count value is a 1. 1 is less than or equals to 5. Yes, it is true. If it is true, what is going to happen? It is going to print a hello. On the screen, you are going to get a statement called as a hello. Once after printing, again the control backs to this particular statement only. Now what is the value of the count? Again count value is 1. It has not been incremented to 2 here. See, first it should become 1, later it should become 2, then 3, 4 and then 5. But what is happening in my program? The count value has not been got incremented. Now you understood the importance of the increment operator? Yes. What we need to do now? After printing, I need to write count plus plus. Is it clear? See, what type of an operator have been used? I have been used a unary operator. Plus plus is an increment operator. What type of an increment it is? It is a postfix increment. Either you can write count plus plus, or you can also write count is equals to count plus 1. Whichever you feel convenient, you can use. Okay, for time being, until you people get familiar, you can write even like this. Count is equals to count plus 1. So let me remove this line. Okay, now what is happening? Before seeing output, let us trace a program. What is the value of the 1 for the first time? Count value will be 1. It will enter into the while loop. While 1 is less than equals to 5, yes, true. What happens? Condition is true. Printf statement will be executed. On the monitor, you get a hello. After displaying a hello for the 1 time, see, hello printed only 1 time. Now, what will be the value of a count? Earlier it was 1, 1 plus 1. What has become now? Now, count value has become 2. That count value 2, again it goes back to the beginning of the while loop. Now, what is the value of a count now? Count value will be 2. 2 is less than or equals to 5? Yes. Again, it will print hello. After that, again it will encounter this statement. What is the current value of account? 2. For that, how much I am adding? 1 I am adding. Now, what is the value of account? Count has become a 3. Again, it goes back. 3 is less than or equals to 5. Yes. Again, it will print hello. Now, 3 plus 1. Count value was a 3. Again, for that 1 I am going to add. What is the value of account? Count value has become 4. Again, it goes back to the count. 4 is less than or equals to 5. Yes. Again, it will print hello. Now, what is the value of a count? 4. For that, how much I'm adding? Plus 1. Now, what is the value of a count? Count has become 5. And again, it goes back to the beginning of a while loop. So, 5 is less than or equal? 5 is less than 5? No. 5 is equals to 5? Yes. See, this is a relational operator. Less than or equals to operator have been used. So, count is, that is 5 is equals to 5. Yes. Condition is true. Then what is going to happen? Hello will be get printed. Now, what is the value of a count? 5, it has become 5. So, for that 5, plus 1 I am adding. Now, what is the current value of a count? 6. Again, it goes up. 6 is less than or equals to 5. Condition failed. The condition has not been got satisfied. So, what happens? It will come directly outside of the while loop. What is there inside outside of the while loop? Nothing is there. So, that program will be get stopped. Did you people got understood the tracing part of the particular program? Okay, now let us see the program output, how it works. So this is what, say hello 1, hello 2, 3, 4, 5. So hello has been got printed for totally 5 times. Now you may say even this program line has also been got increased. Now see here, suppose if I make the count value as a 50. How many times, how many lines I'm changing? Not even changing any line, just changing its value. Now the program will be executing for 50 times. Is it easy or not? When compared to the manual part, see if it was a manual, see it is stopped. It has been got stopped. It is not repeating here. Total it has been printed for 50 times. Suppose if I want to make it as a 500, I can make even it as a 500. Just by changing a value, with the particular loop has to can be get executed. Now you people have understood the definition of a loop. What is the definition of a loop? A loop is a statement or a group of statement. So which is a loop? Which loop I'm using here? I'm using a while loop. How many lines my particular loop is having? Totally 2 lines my particular while loop is having. So a loop is a statement or a group of statement which executes for a finite number of times. Here, what is the finite time value? That is a 5. Did you people have got understood the concept of a while loop? Okay, so in the last example, we have been seen a program which displays hello for 5 times. Now we will write one more program similar to that only using while loop. Instead of printing hello for 5 times, this time we will print numbers, that is from 1 to 5. Instead of hello, what we are printing? We need to print numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need this as an output. Is it? Okay, come on. Let us write a program for that. See, what are the things I need? I need one variable. Is it clear? And what type of a values I am printing? I am printing integer values only. So, to print these integer values, I need one variable called as an integer. So, what I will do? I will take int num as a variable. Okay. Even you can take a count or even you can take a variable called as a I. Anything you can take, any variable, a valid variable, you can take it. There is no problem in it. So I am taking int num. So what is the first rule says there? We need to write initialization first. Always remember that we need to first make a initialization. So num is equals to, what I need to do now? I need to write num is equals to. What should be the first value? First value should be 1. Yes, first value should be 1. So what is this line is called as? Initialization. This line is called as an initialization. So one part of the work has been got completed. Now after initialization, what I'm having? I need to have a test condition. Nothing but an end point. I need to write a while. So while, from where I need to start? I need to start with a 1. I can't write 1 less than or equals to 5. Is it clear? Because that 1 has to be get changed to 2. 2 has to be get changed to 3. 3 should be changed to 4. Like this. So for that, I need to take a variable only. So I need to write a while num is less than or equals to 5. So what is this thing is called? This is called as a test condition. This line, what we are having here, num is less than or equals to 5, similarly to our previous example only. Is it or not? Because it is repeated, our loop is repeating for 5 times. Why? Num is less than or equals to 5. Okay, if you remember, last time I have written printf hello.
But now I don't want to write hello here. What I need to write now, I want output as a first time it should get a 1, next 2, 3 and so on. So where are these values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be stored into a variable called as a num. So what I do is that I will write printf percentage d comma num. So what is this line will be doing? This line is going to print the value of a number. So now I have written a statement printf percentage d num. We have seen if I don't write initialization, what happens? So in this example, what I will be getting 1111111 for infinite times if I miss increment operator. So what I need to do is that I want to stop after 5. So there I am writing num is equals to num plus 1. Each time it should be get incremented by 1. So you can write num is equals to num plus 1, or you can also write in short num plus plus. So in upcoming classes I will be using the concept of a num plus plus. You can write a num plus plus, or even you can write plus plus num, whichever you feel convenient you can use it. So again, only in this particular program I will be writing like this. So num is equals to num plus 1. So now how the particular program will execute? What is the first value? First value is a 1. 1 is less than or equals to 5. Yes, it is true. If it is true, what it will be printing on the screen? It will be printing 1. Once after printing 1, what is the next line? We are having num is equals to num plus 1. So this is called as an increment statement. Is it clear? Okay, spelling mistake. It is an increment statement. So what is the value of a num I have been displayed? 1. For that 1, I am adding a 1 more 1. So what is the value of this num has become 2. Again, it goes back to the beginning of the while loop. One thing you need to remember, loop will never go to the initialization part. Loop will always come to the beginning. See, this is called as a beginning line of a loop. So now what is the value of a num has become? Num value has become a 2. 2 is less than or equals to 5. Yes, it is true. If it is true, what happens? It enters into the body of the while loop. After entering into the body of the while loop, what is the value it will be displayed? It has displayed 1. Now this time it is going to print 2. After printing 2, again the value of a num will be get incremented. 2 plus 1. What is the current value of num? 3. 3 is less than or equals to 5, s. Once again it will come here, it will print the value of a number. So what is the value of a number? 3 will be get printed. So in order to understand this printf percentage d number, it is called as a formatted output statement. You can refer my previous video for this. Exactly, if you have any particular questions or queries, so, or if you have missed that particular class, go and visit the particular video where I have been clearly told you how to work with the formatted output statements. Okay, and the 3 will be get displayed. Later again that 3 will be incremented to 1. That means it becomes 4. The num value has become a 4. So 4 is less than or equals to 5, s. After that again it will come here, printf percentage d num. So it will print here 4. After printing 4, again the num value will be incremented. Now the what is the value of num? Num has become 5. 5 is equals to 5, s. The condition is true. Once the condition is true, again it will enter into the body of the while loop. What is there in the body of the while loop? Printf number. So it is going to print 5 here. See, this will be printed on the monitor. It will not be printed here only. Just I am showing you the tracing part. So after printing 5, again the value of a number will be incremented because this line is present still in the while loop only. Now the num value has become a 6. Again it goes back here. Then what is the value of a num? 6 is less than equals to 5. Condition is false. It comes out of the particular program. This is how we are going to get output as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let us see the particular output. Before that, I will comment this particular line. Even this also, I will comment. Just a minute, this also comment. Now shall we run the program? See, we got the output as 1 2 3 4 5. See, for the sixth time the loop has got terminated. Suppose if I want to these numbers 1 2 3 4 5 in the next line, just here you write slash n. Once again you check the output.
you got the difference between the previous output and this output. See here, each line is having a 1-1 number. So this is how our program will be working, while loop will be working. Now suppose think that now I don't want to print from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to print it from 51, 52, 53, 54, 55. Instead of printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I want to print from 51 to 55. See students, now what is the starting value here? Starting value is 51. That means what it becomes? A initialization. Where it is ending? It is ending at a 55. In between 51 to 55, what is the difference of each one? There is an increment of 1-1 value. So now what should be the value of a num? Num value I should make it as a 51. Up to where it should work? Up to 55 it should work. Is it being clear? Okay, we will see even this output also. So let me compile the program. See, I made it as 51, 52, 53, 54 and 55. See, this is how the loops helps us. So I have not changed any part of the code. I have not changed any lines of my program. Just I have changed the values. Just by changing a value, our program can be get worked. Is it been clear? If you have any particular questions, please comment here. Is it clear? So those questions, I will try to solve it in the next videos. See, like this, we can work with many number of, programs. As many number of programs we try to practice, so much easy it will be having. So if you have any questions, please send a comment. Thank you.